पराबोला। वी ऑल नो हाउ अ पराबोला इज फॉर्मड बाय इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ अ प्लेन विद अ कोनिक, बट अगेन एज आई सेड इट इज जस्ट फॉर यू टू नो व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड अ कोनिक। देयर इज नो यू नो रिलेशन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर डायग्राम विद व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी एक्चुअली। सो व्हाट इज द लोकस डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ पराबोला? सो व्हाट्स द लोकस डेफिनेशन? जस्ट लाइक वी हैड अ लोकस डेफिनेशन फॉर अ सर्कल, राइट, वी विल हैव अ लोकस डेफिनेशन ऑफ अ पराबोला एज वेल। So parabola is basically defined as locus of or path traced by a moving point, path traced by a moving point on a plane such that the distance of the point from a fixed point is equal to the distance or its distance from a fixed line. Okay, so as per this definition, let's say there is a fixed point, I'll call it as S. And let's say there is a fixed line. Let's say I call it as D equal to zero. Okay. Now there is a point P. This is a moving point. Okay. It is moving in such a way that it is maintaining the same distance from this point as from this line. In other words, SP should be equal to PM. In other words, SP should be equal to PM. So if this point moves in such a way that these two distances are equal, okay, so let's say it comes here, okay, then again the perpendicular dropped is same as this distance, okay. It may not be appearing like that, but let me draw a fish diagram. Okay, let's say it comes here, okay, let's say it comes here, let's say it comes here, okay, let's say it comes here. So whatever point I'm choosing, okay, these points are such points such that if you drop a perpendicular from this point onto the line and take the distance of that point from the S point, they will all be, both the distances will be equal. Okay, so the path traced by this fellow P will be something like a curve which is looking like this. Okay, this is basically your parabola. Okay, and this fixed point that you have, that fixed point is called the focus. This point is called the focus. Okay, and this line that you have, that line is called the directrix. Okay, now many people ask me, sir, where was the focus and directrix for a circle? Because circle is also a part of the conic, right? So if parabola shows a focus, so should circle show, right? Now remember, the circle's focus is actually as it at its center, okay, and its directrix is actually at infinity. Now this is something which I will talk about when I do ellipse with you. Every conic has actually two foci and two directrices. Every conic has two foci and two directrices. So for a circle, the two foci coincide at the center and two directrices are located at plus minus infinity. That's why we never draw it. Okay. Now, when you start stretching this circle a bit, it takes the form of an ellipse. Ellipse has got the two foci separated out, you can say S1, S2, from the center. And these two directrices, they come at finite distances. They come at finite distances. Okay. Now let's say if you further separate out, let's say you further start pulling this, then what will happen? One of the foci and one of the directrix will disappear to infinity and you will be left with something like this structure. So you'll see one focus and one directrix only. This will become a parabola. Okay. Now the other arm and the other focus and the directrix which went to infinity will come again back from negative side of infinity. And this will give you a hyperbola. Okay. And slowly when they collate, they will actually become a pair of straight lines. Okay, so this is the transition normally that these conic sections actually face. Anyways, we'll talk about it when we are discussing it in more detail. As of now, this is just a small story I wanted to tell you just to relate all the conic sections with each other. Now, let's talk about some terminologies, some terms that we are going to use for a parabola. By the way, just to tell you the practical use of parabola, the biggest practical use of a parabola is in parabolic reflectors. I'm sure you would have seen the headlight of your cars, right? I don't know whether it is seen right now, but in Corolla cars, you see that there would be a structure like this you can see from the side. Okay. So those are basically parabolic reflectors. Okay. And what is the purpose of this parabolic reflectors? So they are basically two light bulbs. Okay. One is kept at the focus. If you switch on the light bulb, which is on the focus, after hitting the parabolic reflector, it will become parallel to the road actually. Okay. Actually, it becomes parallel to the axis of the parabola. This is called the axis. We'll talk about it. Okay. And if you switch the other one, it will get reflected and it will show you some nearby object on the road. Okay. So parabolic reflectors are used in the headlamps of the car. It is also used in the field of surgery where let's say the doctors will normally, let's say they want to destroy a stone in the kidney. Okay. So they'll put the stone at the focus and they will pass laser beam after hitting the parabolic reflector will pass through the stone and it'll destroy the stone. Okay. Concave convex mirrors are spherical mirrors, my dear. They're not parabolic mirrors. They are part of a sphere. Concave and convex mirrors come from part of a sphere. They don't come from a part of a parabola. Okay. Anyways. So let us look into the terms that we are going to use. So please be aware of these terms. We are going to use it time and again. So let me again draw the directrix. And we'll do one thing. I'll draw one parabola and keep. In case I keep requiring it, I'll draw in parabola and keep. Sir, how is this a parabola? I will make it a parabola, don't worry. Yeah. Okay. So for the purpose of understanding, think it's a parabola. Okay. So directrix is here and let's say your focus is here. Okay. Let's say this is your focus. Fine. Now, all of you please understand few terms that we are going to use. We already know that this is called focus. This is called focus. Why it is called focus? Because if you pass a ray which is parallel to the axis of the parabola. Now I'll draw the axis also. Axis is a line which is passing through the focus of the parabola and perpendicular to the directrix. In other words, axis is such a line which divides the parabola into two symmetrical halves. Okay, this is called the axis of the parabola. By the way, I'll do one thing. I'll take an image of this and keep because I may need this time and again. One second. Come down, yeah. Normally, I keep using the same figure, so I don't want to draw it over and over again. But doesn't a spherical mirror give a parallel? Yes, but they have spherical aberrations. That's why they have been discontinued. Kinshuk, if you see the ambassador cars which are given to your dad by the army, okay, they will have spherical mirrors. Okay, but they have been discontinued because of the spherical aberrations in them. So parabolic reflectors have now replaced spherical mirrors. Okay, so those were the shortcomings of those ambassador lights which we used to have. People having ambassador cars, I mean, I used to own one when I was very small. My dad used to have one. He bought it in 19, 87 or something, and the mirrors used to be like full round and all. Okay, so those used to have a lot of issues. Anyways, so this is called the focus. This is called the directrix. This is called the axis. The point where the axis meets the parabola, that is called the vertex. This point is called the vertex. Okay. Now remember, vertex is the midpoint of N and S. N is the point where the axis is hitting the directrix. Okay. So this is your directrix. So this point N, S, V is the midpoint of it. Okay. So I'll write it down here. Vertex is the midpoint of N and S. Why is the midpoint? Because you know the definition itself says any point on the parabola should be equidistant from the line and from this point. So it has to be midpoint. In this case, it has to be midpoint. Okay. And also remember, axis is perpendicular to the directrix. Always, it is true for any parabola. Axis is perpendicular to the directrix. Okay. Next important term that we need to understand is chord. Okay, so what is a chord? What is a chord? A chord is basically a line which connects any two points on the parabola. So let's say I connect these two points. Okay, this line segment will be called as a chord of the parabola. Okay, and there's something called focal chord. So let's say I join two points which passes through the focus. Okay, then this line will be called as, or this part will be called as the focal chord. Okay, then there's something called double ordinate. Double ordinate is a line connecting any two points on the parabola, which basically makes it perpendicular to the axis. This will be called as double ordinate. Why the name double ordinate is because the endpoints of this double ordinate will have the same value of y, but of course opposite sign would be there in this case. That is why it is called double ordinate. Don't go by the literal meaning that the ordinate will be two times. So the endpoints of the double ordinate, the y coordinate in this case will be same but of opposite sign. Is it fine? If a double ordinate happens to pass through the focus, then that particular chord or that particular double ordinate will be called as the latus rectum. Latus rectum. Latus means side, rectum means line. So as you can see, it is drawn at the side. Okay. Latus rectum is basically the shortest focal chord. Latus rectum is the shortest focal chord of the parabola. Okay, so again, I'll repeat all the terms once again. This fixed point is your focus. This line is your directrix. A line which is passing through the focus and perpendicular to the directrix, or you can say it is symmetrically dividing the parabola into two equal halves, that is called the axis. Any line connecting any two points or any chord connecting any two points is called the chord. Okay, I use the word chord for explaining a chord. So any line segment connecting any two points on the parabola is the chord. If a line is perpendicular to the axis and connecting two points on the parabola, that is called a double ordinate. If the double ordinate happens to pass through the focus, it is called the latus rectum. Okay. And any chord which is passing through the focus is called the focal chord. So far, these terms should be well known to you. Okay. Any questions so far? Okay. Now, what are we studying in this chapter? We are studying coordinate geometry. So where is coordinate coming in? Here, I was only talking about the definition, I was talking about the critical point. So let us introduce coordinate geometry. So coordinate geometry means equations, points. Okay. So I'll be starting with equations of standard parabole. Parabole or parabolas, both are accepted words for multiple parabola. Okay. So standard parabolas or standard parabole. So let me start with one of the standard forms. There are actually four standard parabole. So we'll begin with one of the forms. For that, I will pull out my diagram, which I had put. Okay. Now, in order to get the equation, first of all, I need to fix up my coordinate axes. I need to choose an origin, right? So normally, for the purpose of getting a standard parabola, we choose the vertex as the origin. That means I'm going to align my x and y axes in such a way that my x-axis is along the axis, y-axis is perpendicular to the axis and passing through the vertex. So I choose vertex to be my origin. So in standard parabola, your vertex is chosen as the origin. Okay. So let us now give some coordinates. So the first thing that I would choose is the coordinate of the focus. Since my focus always lies on the axis, which happens to be the x-axis in this case, let me choose the coordinate of the focus to be a comma 0. Now remember, here a represents the distance of the focus from the vertex. And since it is a distance, we always keep it as a positive quantity. So always a will be positive. This is something which is very, very important. Many people, while solving the question, wrongly take A values as a negative value. No, A will always be positive. So if your, let's say your parabola was having its focus on the negative x-axis, you will write a minus A there. Okay. Because minus A being positive will only give you a negative x-axis, correct? So remember this fact, A will always be positive, always. Do not make any mistake about it. I'm putting question marks here so that you never make a mistake. Okay. Now, if this is origin and this is A comma 0, it is very obvious that this point would be minus A comma 0. And if your directrix is parallel to the y-axis, because it is perpendicular to the axis and you have chosen x-axis as your axis, its equation has to be x equal to minus a. Okay. Now, in order to derive the equation of the parabola, we will choose a moving point h comma k over here. Okay. So h comma k locus will give me the equation of the parabola. So I will use the fact that this distance, let me call it sp, pm should be equal to sp, or sp should be equal to pm. So what is SP? SP is under root of H minus A the whole square, K minus 0 the whole square. What is PM? PM is nothing but it will be, if you see, the distance here would be H plus A mod. Okay. So equation of a line is known, point is known, the distance here will be H plus A mod. Okay. Now, having got SP equal to PM relation, let's square both the sides. If you square both the sides, you will end up getting h minus a the whole square plus k square is h plus a the whole square. Let's try to simplify this. So k square is equal to h plus a the whole square minus h minus a the whole square, which gives you h plus a plus h minus a and h plus a minus h plus a. Okay. So this clearly gives you k square is equal to 2h times 2a, or k square is equal to 4ah, or you can say, generalizing it, you can say y square is equal to 4ax, right? So for such a parabola, for such a standard form of a parabola, your equation of this parabola will become y square is equal to 4ax. Okay. So please note, for such a case, your vertex will be at origin. Your focus will be at a comma 0. your directrix will be x equal to minus a. Your axis equation will be y equal to 0. Okay, what else you need? I think this is more than enough. Now, I would request you all to give me the length of the lattice rectum. So if I draw the lattice rectum for such a standard case, can you tell me the length of the lattice rectum in terms of A? What is the length of this lattice rectum? LR length. I know most of you have done this in school. Instantaneously, you will say 4A. Am I right? Yeah, I know you have done it. So let's do it from as if you have not learned this before. So see, when you're talking about, when you're talking about the length of the lattice rectum, let's say I call this point as point L1 and call this point as L2. So both L1 and L2 will have the x coordinate as A only, right? Let's say y coordinate is k for the time being. So A comma k should satisfy this curve. So you can say k square is equal to 4AA. So k square is going to come out to be 4A square. So k will be equal to plus minus 2A. Now remember, since A is a positive quantity, to signify your top value, or you can say the top coordinate, you'll have to use plus 2A. And here you'll have to use minus 2A. So the length here will be the distance between A comma 2A and A comma minus 2A, which happens to be 4A. Okay. So please make a note of this. That is another thing that we need to keep in mind. Length of lattice rectum is 4A units. You don't have to write a mod over here because A is already a positive quantity. So it'll be 4A units. Now, before we go for a break, I'll quickly tell you what about the other forms of the or other standard forms of the parabola. So this is just one of the standard forms. Remember, there are four standard forms. This is just one of the standard forms. Anything that you would like to copy from here, please do so, because I'm going to change the slide to the next. Done. Okay, so other standard forms will be the one where your parabola is opening. Oh, let me just choose the same colors which I have used because. I mean, it's a crooked one, I believe. Okay. This is your directrix. Correct? What is wrong with this? Yeah. This is called, the previous one is called the rightward opening parabola. I'll name it. I think I did not name it. So this is a standard form and we will refer to this standard form as rightward opening parabola. What we'll call? Right opening or rightward opening parabola. Okay. The next one which we are doing, that will be called as leftward opening parabola. Yeah, this will be called as the leftward opening parabola. Okay, so here your focus is at minus a comma 0. Directrix is x equal to a. Vertex is still at origin. Okay, this is your y axis. This is your x axis. For such a case, the equation will become y square is equal to minus 4ax. We don't have to derive it separately because it is just like taking the reflection of the rightward opening parabola about the y axis. Now, all of you have undergone a rigorous crash course with us, not crash course, bridge course with us. So I've been habituated to saying crash course because your seniors are undergoing crash course. So you have done a bridge course with us where you have learned that if a curve gets reflected about the y-axis, we actually change the sign of x. So instead of, okay, let me write in a more proper way. Instead of 4ax, now you will write 4a minus x. So as a result, this becomes y square is equal to minus 4ax. Okay, so few important points to be noted. So please note that for such a case, your vertex will be at origin. Your focus will be at minus a comma 0. Directrix equation, I've already written x equal to a. Okay. Length of the lattice rectum, length of LR will be again 4a units. No change. Okay. So this is your leftward opening parabola. Coming to upward opening. Let me choose this color. Okay. So this is a upward opening parabola. So for upward opening parabola, the focus is at 0, comma a. This is y equal to minus a. Vertex is still at origin. This is your x-axis. This is your y-axis. Okay. Now, if somebody says derive the equation of this parabola, you don't have to again reinvent the wheel. You just realize the fact that your rightward opening parabola, if you reflect it about a line y equal to x. So let's say, if you reflect it about a line y equal to x, it will actually become an upward opening parabola. See? Okay. So this parabola is actually the reflection of rightward opening parabola about y equal to x line. Okay. And again, if you recall your bridge course days, we had done this concept that if you're reflecting a curve about y equal to x line, just change the position of x and y. Okay, just change the position of x and y. So in y square is equal to 4ax, if you change the position of x and y, it becomes x square is equal to 4ay. Okay, so in this case, please note, this is first of all called upward opening parabola. Critical points here, your vertex again at origin. Okay, focus 0, comma a. Directrix equation, y equal to minus a, length of lattice rectum will still remain 4a units because on reflection about y axis or x axis or whatever you're doing, it doesn't change the length of the lattice rectum. So this is your third standard form. Okay, now going to the fourth standard form. In the fourth standard form, we are going to reflect the parabola downwards. So I'll take the last one. Okay. And directrix will be here. Okay. So this is your x-axis, y-axis. Focus will be 0, comma minus a. Y equal to a will be the directrix, 0, comma 0 will be the vertex. So for such cases, just have to do one thing, change your y with a minus y, because we know that when the graph is reflected about x-axis, the sign of y gets changes. So the sign of y gets changed and it becomes x square is equal to minus 4ay. Okay, so this is a downward opening parabola. So please make a note, the critical points over here, the vertex will be again at origin, no change. Focus, as I've already drawn, 0, comma minus a. directrix will become y equal to a, length of lattice rectum is again 4a units. Okay. As of now, we'll take a small break. On the other side of the break, we'll talk about some few basic questions and then we'll move on to the generalized version of a parabola. All right. I hope everybody is back. So before going for a break, we had done the four standard cases of a parabola. Correct? Guys, when you look at these equations for a very, very long time, even in school and now, you get a feeling that parabola equations always look like y square is equal to 4ax or plus minus, or x square is equal to 4ay plus minus. Now, don't get me wrong over here. These are standard forms only. Your parabola equation can become as complicated as your general form of a conic. So a parabola equation can look as ugly as this. Are you getting my point? Right? So in order to make you realize this, I will take a small question to begin with. My question here is, find the equation of a parabola. Find the equation of a parabola whose focus is at -1, -2, and directrix is x minus 2y plus 3 equal to 0. Everybody please solve this question. And then after solving this question, we will see how complicated, or how we can say lengthy and ugly an equation of a parabola can look like. Because many people, we just see parabola as that y square is equal to 4ax or y x square is equal to 4ay. No. Those are of course the equation, but those are very, very simplistic cases. They're very standard cases, right? And the reason why they are standard is because they're very simple. Okay. But you can have an ugly looking expression as well. So first solve this question and then we'll talk about it. Just type done. If you're done, follow the locus definition here, Kinshuk. What is the locus definition of a parabola? Parabola is the locus of a point which moves in such a way that its distance from this fixed point should be same as the distance from this line. Isn't it? Follow that. Just say done once you're done, okay? Let me sketch it also to a certain extent. This line is nothing but x by 2 plus 3 by 2. X by 2 plus 3 by 2 line will look like this. Okay. And its focus is here, minus 1 comma minus 2. So your parabola is of this nature. I'm just drawing a rough sketch. Okay, this will become the axis of the parabola. This is your vertex. Okay. Now, what is the locus definition? Locus definition is, if I take any point h, k on the parabola, its distance from the focus should be same as its distance from the directrix, isn't it? This distance and this distance should be same, correct? And this line is already x minus 2y plus 3 equal to 0. So distance of the point P from S will be h plus 1 the whole square k plus 2 the whole square under root. This should be the distance of h comma k from this particular line, which is h minus 2k plus 3 mod by under root of 5. Okay, so what I have done, I have just used the fact that sp is equal to pm. Okay, square it, simplify it. So I'll directly do a lot of calculations here. So I'll take 5 on the other side and I'll square the whole term. So it'll become 5 times h plus 1 the whole square, k plus 2 the whole square. On this side, you will have h minus 2k plus 3 the whole square. If you collect your h square terms, you will have 4h square. If you collect your k square terms, you will have plus k square. If you collect your xy terms will come from here. So it'll give you 4hk terms. And this will give you 10h from here minus 6s. So this will be 4h. And y will be, this is 4k, 20, 20 plus 12, 32k. And constant terms would be 5, 25, 25 minus 9, which is 16. Okay, simplify it. I mean, you don't have to follow me for simplifying it, right? So now if you generalize this, you will see that this is how an equation of a parabola can look like. Okay, that means your equation of a parabola will have all the characteristics that a conic can have. Ax square, by square, 2hxy, 2gx, 2fy plus c equal to 0. So don't be under the impression that parabola is always like y square is equal to 4ax or y square is equal to minus 4ax or x square is equal to 4ay or x square is equal to minus 4ay. Okay. So such complicated questions or such complicated parabola, I should say, not questions, question was not complicated. Such complicated equation of the parabola can also come. Normally, such kind of parabola we call as oblique parabola. Okay, it's an oblique parabola. That means it is not rightward opening or leftward opening or upward opening or downward opening. It's something oblique. That means at a certain angle it is opening. Okay. For school exams, I don't think so you will be tested on this. Okay. In JE also, not many questions will be asked. Okay, but whatever is going to be asked, we are going to take that up once we are done with our, you know, school exams. Any question, anybody? Okay. Now we'll come back to our standard cases. So some problems based on standard cases. So problems on standard parabola. So let me start with some questions on standard parabola. Okay. Very simple question I'll begin with. Find the coordinates of the foci, equation of the directrix and length of the lattice rectum for the following four cases. Okay, we'll quickly do it just to understand that all of you are good with your basics. Okay, and will not waste much time. First one, let us start. Y square is equal to 8x. 8x you can write 4 into 2 into x. Correct? So your a is actually 2 over here. Right? Now let's figure out what's the coordinate of the foci. In fact, there will be only one focus. So foci is a misnomer here. So what will be focus? Let's write it down. What will be the directrix equation? Let's write it down. And what is the length of the lattice rectum? Let's write it down. Yeah. So all of you, please write down on your screen, write down on your chat box. Focus is 2,0. Very good, Chambo. Directrix. X equal to minus 2. Brilliant. Length of the lattice rectum. 8 units. Awesome. Okay. Second one. X square is equal to 6y. 6y you can write it as 4 into 1.5. 4 into 1.5y. Okay. So here A is 1.5. So tell me focus. Focus. Yes, Vaibhav, absolutely. Yes. Focus is 0,1.5. Very good. Directrix. Y equal to minus 1.5. Very good. LR. 6 units. Very good. Very good. So all of you are comfortable with your basics. So I don't have to worry much about it. Third one. Y square is equal to minus 12x. So minus 12x, you will write it as minus 4 into 3 into x. So what is A here? What is A here? A is 3. Never say minus 3. Okay. Never say minus 3. Yes. So what is the focus here? It's a leftward opening parabola. So focus is minus 3, 0. Very good. Directrix. X equal to A. Lattice rectum. 12 units. Very good. Next one. Fourth one. X square is equal to minus 16y. Minus 16y, I will write it like minus 4 into 4 into y. So A here is going to be 4. Yes. So where is focus? Where is focus? It's a downward opening parabola. 0, minus 4. Very good. Equation of the directrix. Y equal to 4. Length of the lattice rectum. 16 units. Very good. So everybody is pretty fine with it. Okay. All right. Now we will move towards the generalized form of a parabola, also called the shifted form of the parabola. Okay. So what we did was those cases where your vertex was at origin. Okay. But in these cases, your vertex will not be at the origin. It will be shifted somewhere in space. But its axis will still be parallel to the x-axis or y-axis as discussed in the standard cases. Okay. So right now, I have basically shown a parabola where the vertex has now gone to alpha comma beta. And let's say the distance of the focus from the vertex is still A. Okay. And the axis of the parabola is parallel to the x-axis. Can you tell me what will be the equation for such a parabola? All of you first write it down on your notebook. What do you think will be the equation of a parabola whose distance between the vertex and the focus is A and the vertex has gone to a coordinate or a place called alpha comma beta? This was your origin. This is your y-axis. This is your x-axis. So how will you write this equation? So you will say, sir, simple. It is just a case where your standard form of a parabola got shifted alpha units right, okay, and beta units up, correct? When a curve gets shifted to the right and up, what do you do with your x and the y values? When a curve shifts to the right, we normally replace our x with x minus alpha and we replace our y with y minus beta. I hope you are all aware of this. Yes or no? Okay. Now, Shraddha is making a mistake. Shraddha, your curve got shifted right and up, not the origin. Origin will go in the reverse direction. Guys, let me tell you, the inside story is the curve doesn't shift. What shifts? Origin shifts. Correct? If you recall your shifting of origin concept, you would recall that when the origin shifts to h comma k, what do we do? We replace our x with capital X plus h and we replace our y with capital Y plus k. Do you remember this or not? Do you remember this shifting of origin concept? So now many people will start asking, sir, why didn't you write then y plus beta and x plus alpha. Guys, when the vertex has gone to alpha comma beta, it means your origin has shifted to minus alpha minus beta. See, originally it was like this, right? Now, how should you shift your origin so that your curve starts looking like this? You will say you have to take your origin to minus alpha minus beta, right? So your origin comes to this position. So if your origin comes to this position only, then your curve starts looking like this, isn't it? So your x will get changed with x plus h, and h here is minus alpha. And your y will get replaced with y plus k, and y is minus beta. Don't confuse, okay? Don't confuse. This is the concept of shifting of origin. Okay. Any questions here? Similarly, if your curve was your x square is equal to 4ay, and you were shifting your origin, or you are shifting your vertex to any position alpha comma beta, you just have to do a simple act. Take the standard form, change your x with x minus alpha, change your y with y minus beta. That's it. Okay. So let me begin with a simple question for you all. Find vertex, focus, equation of directrix, length of lattice rectum. Okay. Equation of axis for this parabola. I'll just give you one of them first to begin with. Y plus 1 the whole square is equal to 8 x minus 2. Okay, so first of all, think very carefully and let's answer these five things: vertex, focus, equation of directrix, length of lattice rectum, equation of axis. So all of you first think carefully and then we'll solve this question. And if somebody is done, just type done. If you feel you want to draw a diagram to solve it, you are most welcome to do it. Archit is done. Very good, Archit. That was fast. Just type done, Ruchita. If you're done, just say done. Okay, we'll discuss the answers. I don't want you to take the effort of writing everything. Okay, Ruchita is done, Stuti is done, Archit is done, Shraddha is done. Okay, so when you look at this, it basically gives you an idea that y square is equal to 8x was shifted to right and one down. Okay, so one down and two right will bring the vertex at this position. So this was your parabola. This was your parabola. Okay. So this is your parabola. Okay. This will be your vertex. This will be your vertex. This will be your axis. Okay. And focus will be somewhere over here. This will be your focus. Okay. And of course, lattice equation directrix would be somewhere over here. I'm not exactly commenting on its equation right now, but I'm just drawing one over here. Okay. Anyways. So first of all, vertex is clear to everybody. Vertex should be at 2 comma minus 1. 2 comma minus 1 will be the vertex. Okay. Second thing that you would observe here is that in this case of a parabola, your a value was actually a 2. Correct? So if you compare this with 4a, your a value was actually a 2. Correct? So that means you have to move 2 units on this side to get the focus, correct? So this is 4, minus 1. Okay, so vertex is 2, minus 1. Focus is 4, minus 1. Correct? What about equation of the directrix? Directrix would be a line parallel to the y-axis, and it would be passing through this point. Now, what will be this point? This point will be 0, minus 1. Correct? Yes or no? Have I made any mistake? Okay. So when I say 0, minus 1, it will actually become your y-axis only. Correct? So your directrix will actually be aligned along the y-axis only. Okay? So directrix equation will be x equal to 0. Correct? Next, what was required? Length of lattice rectum. Length of lattice rectum will be 4a only. 4 into 2, which is 8 units. Length of the lattice rectum doesn't change on shifting the parabola. Whether you shift it down, right, up, left, whatever. Length of the lattice rectum will be fixed to 8 units only in this case. Next is equation of the axis. This is a line which is basically y equal to minus 1 line. Okay. Now, how many of you got all these five things correct? Vertex 2 comma minus 1, focus 4 comma minus 1, equation of the directrix x equal to 0, length of the lattice rectum 8 units, equation of the axis y equal to minus 1. Absolutely. Very good. Very good. Those who got it correct. Okay. Now, there are many students who ask me, sir, is there any shortcut to find it? I don't want to draw a diagram and all. Okay. Because people think drawing a diagram is a bonus work, right? We should avoid doing it. No. Drawing diagram is sometimes the only way to solve a question many a times. Okay. Especially in exams like JEE. So never refrain yourself from drawing a sketch. Now, anyway, since you have asked for a method without a diagram, let's discuss it. So here, what do? I'll take the same question again. Y plus 1 the whole square is equal to 8x plus 2. So what do we do here? We do a role change. What role change we do? Instead of y plus 1, we will put a y. Okay. And instead of x plus 2, we'll put a capital X. Okay. Capital Y, capital X. Thereby converting this equation to y square is equal to 8x. Or in a more granular way, y square is equal to 4 into 2 into x. Okay. Now, recall everything that you know about this standard form of a parabola. Where was the vertex of this parabola? The vertex was actually supposed to be at 0, 0, right? 0, 0 for y square is equal to 8x. Vertex is 0, 0, correct? Now, all you need to do is for the case which was given to you, all you need to do is put x as 0 because here this base is 0. Put y as 0 because this y is also 0. And just change the values of capital X, or you can say expressions for capital X and capital Y like this. Solve for X and you will end up getting your vertex coordinate. So this is your answer for the vertex. Okay, as you can see here, this is what you had obtained. Okay. Now, focus. Focus for this parabola was a comma 0. That is 2 comma 0, right? Okay. So just do a role change. Just call x as 2, y as 0. And put your x as x plus 2. Okay. And put your y as, I hope I have got, have I done any mistake in copying? Ayyo, Rama Krishna. This was x minus 2. Sorry. Yeah. Yeah, So x will become a 4, and capital Y was y plus 1, so y will become a minus 1. Okay, so 4 comma minus 1 will become your focus. As you can see over here, we have already got that. Okay, next is directrix equation. So for this, the directrix equation is going to be x equal to minus a. Now you change your x with x minus 2, and this will automatically reduce to x equal to 0. Okay, so all you're doing is a role change. So whatever you knew for this, you write it down and just do a role change of capital X in terms of small x and capital Y in terms of small y. That's it. Next was equation of the axis. For this case, the equation of the axis was your x-axis. X-axis is capital Y equal to 0. So just write Y plus 1 equal to 0, which is nothing but Y equal to minus 1. Okay. Length of the lattice rectum will be the same. And in this case, you don't have to draw any diagram to solve the question. Make sense? You can solve this question just by doing a role change. If you have understood this concept, let me give you a few problems based on this so that you are, you know, accustomed to it. This is the maximum your school teachers can ask you. Okay, so let's have another example. Again, find number one. I just write down the questions, what we need. Vertex, focus, equation of directrix, equation of axis, length of lattice rectum. Okay. And let me just take a snapshot in case I need it again and again. Okay. And the parabola is y minus 3 the whole square is equal to x plus 2 with a minus sign over it, let's say. Yeah, everybody please solve it. Only after solving the 5 of them, say done. Done. Kinshuk is done. Very good. Ritu done. Anybody else done? Shraddha done. Very good. Okay. So first compare. With which standard case will you compare this? Which standard case was shifted to get this parabola? You will say y square is equal to minus 4ax, sir. Am I right? How did I know minus 4ax? Because of the presence of this minus sign. Okay. So let us do a comparison. So on comparing, your capital Y is small y plus 3. Capital X is small x plus 2. And A, my dear, is 1/4. I hope everybody is fine with this. Okay. Now, recall everything that you know about this parabola. Recall everything. So for this parabola, where was the vertex? Recall it. Where was the focus? Recall it. What was the equation of the directrix? Recall it. What was the equation of axis? Recall it. Okay. What was the length of the lattice rectum? Recall it. Let's do that. So vertex for this guy used to be 0, 0. Focus used to be minus A0. Directrix used to be X equal to A. Okay, let me better write capital X. Okay, so that, yeah, correct. Equation of the axis used to be capital Y equal to 0 and length of lattice rectum used to be 4A units. Okay, now on the very same figure, you just have to do a role change. What role change? Instead of 0, 0, write capital X equal to 0, capital Y equal to 0. Change your capital X to X plus 2. Change your capital Y to Y plus 3. So X becomes minus 2, Y becomes minus 3. So minus 2 minus 3 will be your vertex. Has everybody got this? Give yourself a pat on your back if you have got this. Very good. Next. Minus A comma 0, write it like this. X is minus A, Y is 0. And do a role change. X plus 2 is minus A. Minus A is minus 1/4. And Y plus 3 is 0. So this means your coordinate will be, I'm directly writing it, minus 9 by 4 minus 3. Has everybody got this? Okay. Directrix, already I have written capital X equal to A. That means X plus 2 is 1/4. So directrix equation is X equal to minus 7 by 4, if I'm not mistaken. Or you can also write it 4x plus 7 equal to 0. Has everybody got this? Check, 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 check. Okay. Capital Y equal to 0 means Y plus 3 is equal to 0. So that means this itself is an equation. So check it out. Length of the lattice rectum is 1 unit. Okay. Does it give you a fair bit of idea how to work with these cases? Okay. Got all of them correct. Very good. Very good. Okay. Now, normally the question setter will not be a kind enough person to give you an equation like this. What he will do is he will open this up. He will open the brackets, which you call as simplification, but he will do the complication of it. Okay. And it is our duty to figure it in this way and then figure out the answers. So what we will do is we'll take some questions when the question setter has actually aggravated that situation by opening the brackets. Okay. All right. So let's have this question first of all. This represents a parabola. Okay. Find its vertex, equation of axis, equation of lattice rectum also this fellow has asked. Very good. Coordinates of the focus, equation of the directrix, extremities of the lattice rectum, length of the lattice rectum. In fact, in short, it has asked full bio data of parabola. Okay. Now, before you start solving a question, one very small thing I would like to, inform you. Many people ask me, sir, is this a case of a shifted parabola or is this a case of a oblique parabola? Let me tell this to you very straightforward in the beginning of the process itself. Oblique parabola will always contain xy terms. Does this equation contain any xy term? No, so it is not a case of an oblique parabola. So when there is no xy term, then it is either a case of shifted parabola or standard parabola. But it is not a standard one, because had it been a standard one, it would have been like y square is equal to some constant into x, isn't it? But it has 2y also. So it's a case of shifted parabola. Okay, so let nobody tell you what case of a parabola it is. You can yourself recognize. You can yourself make out. Now solve this question. First, everybody give an honest attempt, then we'll discuss it. Done, sir. Okay. Anybody else? Done, sir. Done. Okay. All right. So here, one more step you need to do, and that step is completing the square. Okay. So first of all, let me write it like this. So normally I separate out the y terms and x terms. Of course, constant I keep with the x terms. Now remember, since this question shows you a quadratic in y, there has to be a completion of square in terms of y. Had it been a quadratic in x, you would have completed a square in x. So that would have been a case of shifting of an upward or a downward opening parabola. Okay. So in this case, since it is very clear that it is a quadratic in y, it has to be either in the form of shifting of rightward opening parabola or a leftward opening parabola. So that will come to know once we complete the square. So add a one. I hope you all are good at the art of completing the square. Okay. I'll go one more step here. I'll do 4 into 1 by 4 times this. Okay. Now, this is y square is equal to 4ax. So here is the role change. Your y role is being played by y plus 1. X role is being played by x minus 4. And your a role is being played by 1/4. Okay. Now, vertex. Where is the vertex of this guy? 0, 0. Correct? So I will write x minus 4 equal to 0. Okay? And y plus 1 equal to 0. So it is 4 comma minus 1. How many of you got this right? 4 comma minus 1. Very good. Excellent. Next, equation of the axis. Equation of the axis for this parabola is capital Y equal to 0, isn't it? The X axis. So capital Y equal to 0. So let me write vertex over here. Axis equation is capital Y equal to 0 means Y plus 1 equal to 0. Okay. Vertex axis. Next is equation of the lattice vector. Now, equation of the lattice rectum is given by capital X equal to A. Okay, if you recall your standard case, your lattice rectum used to be like this. So this is small x equal to A. So here it will become capital X equal to A. So equation of LR will be capital X, which is x minus 4, equal to A. In other words, it is 4x minus 17 equal to 0. How many of you got this correct? Very good. Coordinates of the focus. Coordinates of the focus. The focus of this parabola is capital A comma 0. So X is capital X is your A. Y should be 0. That means you're saying X minus 4 is 1/4 and Y plus 1 is equal to 0. So the coordinates will be 17 by 4 comma minus 1. That will be your focus. Okay. Equation of the directrix. Equation of the directrix for this parabola was capital X equal to minus A. So your X minus 4 will be minus 1 by 4. That will give you 4X minus 15 equal to 0. So this will be the equation of the directrix. This was your focus. Let me bubble it up. Finally, extremities of the lattice rectum. Now, extremities of the lattice rectum, how will you find it out? Now, remember, your parabola is a parabola which has been shifted in such a way that the vertex has gone to 4, minus 1. So, 4, minus 1 is here. Okay. Or you can do one simple activity. You can simply put in the equation x equal to 17 by 4. Okay, so when you put x as 17 by 4 in the equation of the parabola, let's see what values of y it throws out. So y square minus 2y, I hope it is minus or plus, or plus. Minus 17 by 4 plus 5. Okay. So what does this give you? This gives you y plus 1 the whole square is equal to 17 by 4 minus 4, which is 1 by 4. Okay. So automatically from here, y plus 1 comes out to be plus minus half. So your y can be either minus half or it could be minus 3 by 2. So your ends of the lattice rectum will be 17 by 4 comma minus half and 17 by 4 comma minus 3 by 2. Make sense? Shraddha, why? Why it will be 4x plus 15? May I know the reason for that? Is this correct? Directrix? Those who have solved it? Yes. What is the problem, Shraddha? You are saying 4x plus 15? 15, why 15 will come? Okay. Next is the length of the lattice rectum. Length of the lattice rectum is going to be 1 unit. Make sense? Now you know how to deal with these situations also. Okay. Now, before we take on more problems, one small thing I would like to cover with you, and that is the parametric form of a parabola. Just like we did the parametric form for the case of a circle, we'll also do a parametric form for the case of a parabola. And then we'll take a few questions and wind this topic up. And there's nothing more that is required for your school. More than this. But again, just like circle, parabola is also a big chapter. Okay. There are a lot of tangent properties and normal properties that will come up. So parametric form of a parabola. So I will start with a very simple case. Let's start with this guy. Y square is equal to 4ax. Okay. Now, though there can be millions and trillions and zillions of parametric form possible, the one that we prefer using for such a parabola is x equal to 80 square and y is equal to 280. Right? I don't know who came up with this, but the person who came up with this very beautifully, you know, represented this. And you can see that if you try to eliminate the t from x and y, you will end up getting, this equation. So t here is a parameter. Okay. This is one of the widely used parametric form for solving JE level questions. So please keep this in mind. Okay. No problem, Shraddha. No problem. But my question to you is, you suggest me in a similar fashion, what should I have the parametric form for the second standard case? So can you suggest me a parametric form for this guy? Take a clue from this. Very good, Vaibhav. Very good. So for such case, you can take x equal to minus 80 square and y is equal to 280. Excellent. Very good. Okay. Right. Now, for the others, I'll give you one more opportunity. Tell me for x square is equal to 4ay. This is simple. I mean, yes, absolutely. So you say, sir, why don't you change the position of x and y? So x will become 280, y will become 80 square. Okay. Is it fine? Any questions? Okay. And finally, the fourth one, which is not a surprise to anybody. If I have to write for x square is equal to minus 4ay, I will write the parametric form as x equal to 280 and y is equal to minus 80 square. Make sense? Okay. Now, having known this, one small question I would like to you to answer this out. Suggest a parametric form. Find a parametric form for this parabola. Y minus 1 the whole square is equal to minus x plus 2. Suggest a parametric form for this parabola. Please give me your response on the chat box. I want to see everybody's response. Very good, Kinshuk. Kinshuk, आपका वाई कहाँ गया? Okay, very good. Okay, so here you will see that it resembles this format, correct? So you will write x plus 2 as minus a t square. That means your x is minus 2 minus 1/4 t square. And your y, which is y minus 1, you will write it as 2at. That means y is nothing but 1 plus t by 2. So you can suggest a parametric form for this equation to be like this. I'm writing it in one point. Minus 2 minus 4t square and y is equal to 1 plus t by 2. Okay, so this is a parametric form. Make sense? Any questions, any concerns, please do highlight, please ask me. Okay, so for the remaining 15 minutes of the class, we'll do some problem solving. Okay, so we'll make ourselves comfortable with this concept. Okay, so let's have this. Find the equation of a parabola whose vertex is at 2 comma minus 3 and focus is at 0 comma 5. Just let me know, done with your done. I will be happy to see that you have tried it out. Diagram. Guys, nothing can replace a beautiful, almost accurate diagram. Focus is 0, 5. Okay. So focus is somewhere over here. Okay. Vertex is at 2 comma minus 3. 2 comma minus 3 is here. Okay, they're very far apart. So let me just take 2 comma minus 3 here. Okay. 2 comma minus 3. So how will your parabola look like? It will look like this guy. It's a fat one actually. Kinshuk, let me remind you that this is an oblique parabola. Okay, this is an oblique parabola. Here you can see your axis is tilted. Okay, it is not a shifted case of a parabola like what you are thinking of. Okay, it's an oblique parabola. Correct. So for oblique parabola, we need to know the directrix. Right? How will I get the directrix? Who will tell me? How will I get the directrix? This is the vertex. This is the focus. Yeah, absolutely. First of all, it is perpendicular to the axis. So I know the slope because I know your slope of SV. Correct? So what is the slope of SV first of all? slope of SV will be y1 minus y2, y1 minus y2 by x1 minus x2. That's minus 4. So slope of this guy is plus 4, correct? So slope of the directrix will be plus 4, correct? And this point, how will I find out? Remember, V is the midpoint of S and N. Okay, midpoint. No need to use distance also. Midpoint use karo, isn't it? So this guy will become, if I'm not wrong, this will become 4 and this will become minus 11. Okay. Acha, haha, sorry. Thank you, Dev. Thank you. You saved my lot of effort. Yeah, yeah, Ritu. Yeah, sorry. I realized that. Thanks, Dev and Ritu for correcting me. Okay, now directrix equation is what? Y minus y1 is slope times x minus x1. Correct? That means 4y plus 44 is x minus 4. So x minus 4y minus 48 equal to 0. Okay. Now, I will use the locus definition now. I'll say that any point on this particular parabola, the distance from this directrix should be same as the distance from the focus. Even though diagram wise, it doesn't look like that, but you can consider it to be like this. And save your time, just call it as x and y. No need to waste your time writing it as h and k and then writing it in terms of x and y. It was just for your initial understanding that I wrote like this. So brevity is the key. Okay. Now don't waste your time simplifying it. I hope you can simplify it from here on. My idea was just for you to tell how to proceed in these kind of questions. Remember, not all the parabola are your shifted parabola. Not all the parabola are your standard parabola. Okay. Dev, V should be the midpoint of S and some point over here. So what is this point? Midpoint formula use karlo. Hena? Take it as some P comma Q. So P plus 0 by 2 should be 2. So P will be 4. Correct? Q plus 5 by 2 should be minus 3. So Q should be minus 11. Okay. Will you be able to proceed from here on? Any questions? Any doubts? Any kashta? Please let me know. Okay. All good? All right. So we'll move on. We'll take a few more questions. This is something which we have already done. Focus vertex questions we have done. Okay, let's do this one. There are three questions. I can say the three subparts are like three questions. Find the equation of a parabola whose vertex is at 1, 0, focus is at 3, 0. First one, let us do the first one, then we'll come to the second and the third. First one done. Make the diagram. Diagram will speak volumes about it. Yes. Vertex is at 1, 0, my dear friend. Focus is at 3, 0, my dear friend. That means your parabola will look like this, my dear friend. That means it is our rightward opening parabola which has been shifted one unit to the right. Isn't it? Okay. A value is 2. So had the vertex been at origin, it would have been y square is equal to 8x. But actually what had happened? The parabola has moved one unit to the right. So what you will do? This is your answer. Dev, shifting is not clear, my dear friend. What is happening? Is it fine? Second question, please try it out. focus 2,0 and one extremity of its lattice rectum is 2,2. I'm not solving it. Diagram to bana de do yaar. Okay, one extremity is here, 2,2. Which clearly indicates that your parabola should have been like this. Down, 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 down. This is your lattice rectum. Yes. Okay, very good, very good. Kinshuk, very good. Vaibhav. Anybody else who would like to participate? Okay. So guys, this guy is 2A. So you know A is going to be 1. Isn't it? This is half the lattice rectum. Full lattice rectum is 4A. Half of it is 2A. Correct? So your vertex will be when you go back one unit over here. So this guy is 1,0. Correct? A is 1. Vertex is at 1,0. So your equation will be like this. Y square is equal to 4x minus 1. Am I right? Am I right? Any questions here? Vaibhav is absolutely correct. Okay. Kinshuk, where you went wrong? Third one. Third one. Focus 0,-3. Directrix is y equal to 3. Ayyo, this looks like the standard form only. Isn't it? This is the standard form only. Okay. So focus, 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 focus is here. 0,-3. Directrix is y equal to 3, so it is top here. So your parabola will look like this. Okay, so it is x square is equal to minus 4a. A y a is 3, my dear. This is 3, a is 3. So x square is equal to minus 12y. I hope everybody has got this right at least. Okay, next question, last question. Let's do a application. Application. A beam is supported at its end by two supports, which are 12 meters apart. Since the load is concentrated at its center, there is a deflection of 3 cm at the center, and the deflected beam is in the shape of a parabola. How far from the center is the deflection? 1 cm. 1.5 minutes. Draw it out, think it out, and then we'll solve it. Okay, let's draw the diagram. So see what has happened. There is a beam which was kept supported on two supports. Okay. And these two supports were 12 meters apart. Right? And because the beam was heavy at the center, there is a deflection of 3 cm over here. Watch out the units, my dear friends. Watch out the units. One unit is meter, another unit is centimeter. Okay. Now they're asking you how far from the center is the deflection 1 cm. That means how far is this distance? What is D they're asking us? Okay. Now, In order to find it, I will first position my coordinate axes in this way. I'll keep my x-axis like this, and I'll keep my y-axis like this. Okay? In other words, the lowest point of my beam, I will take it as the origin. Okay? Now, if you know the parabola which is positioned in this way, we know it has to be x square is equal to 4ay. But what is a? How do I figure that out? Not to worry. If you take this point, let me call this point as a P. We know that this point is 6, 3/100. Am I right? So this equation must be satisfied by 6, 3/100. So 36 is equal to 4a into 3/100. In other words, a will become 300. Correct me if I'm wrong. Okay. That means your parabola is x square is equal to 1200y. Okay. Now, I want to know the location of this coordinate. This is d comma, correct me if I'm wrong. This is d comma 2/100. Isn't it? Because it is d units to the right. And since it is one down from the x-axis, it is two up. Actually, it doesn't look like from the diagram. So it is two up. So if I put my d comma 2/100 in this particular expression, I should be able to get my d. So d square is equal to 1200 into 2/100. That means d is equal to root of 24. That is 2√6 meters. Okay. So from the center, if you go 2√6 to the right or to the left, you will end up getting the deflection as 1 centimeter. Is this correct? Vaibhav, a small mistake you did. You thought that 1 centimeter is the y coordinate, but 1 centimeter is not, 2 centimeter is the y coordinate. Is it fine? Any questions, any concerns? Okay. So we'll give this topic a rest here, and the next class would be on